Want to speak real Turkish from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at TurkishClass101.com.
Hey guys, I'm Seda. Welcome to TurkishClass101.com. Today we'll talk about comparatives and superlatives. And about this subject, it's really easy to understand in Turkish. So I think by the end of this video, you'll be able to compare things by just yourself. So just sit back and relax and watch it, okay? So, for comparison, we need adjectives like beautiful, nice, ugly, cold, hot. And for Turkish, let's use one. Let's pick beautiful. What was beautiful in Turkish? It was güzel. Güzel. Let's say a regular sentence. Hava güzeldir. Hava güzel. Dir. If you remember the rule for Turkish to be verb in the third conjugation, it's like is or are in English. You can say it or not say it. Generally, we don't say it if it's not a very scientific or factual sentence. We just skip it. So I would just say hava güzel, but hava güzeldir is also correct, but more proper, not very daily. But keep that in mind that there is a dirdir, tırtır at the end of these sentences. So that was just a reminder of to be verb in Turkish. So let's go back to our comparison. For comparatives, you just add daha, daha, daha. So, if I want to say the weather is more beautiful, we wouldn't use it in English like that, but nicer, better in Turkish. Hava, daha, güzel. Hava, daha, güzel. Hava, daha, güzel. Hava, daha, güzel. Or let's see, let me check my examples. If you want to say it like this, this tree is better than that tree. Let's say it like that to compare two things and we use them together. This tree is better than that tree. That's our sentence. Bu ağaç o ağaçtan daha iyi. Bu ağaç o ağaçtan daha iyi. So if I would translate this literally, I would translate it like this. This tree from that tree better is. This is the structure of Turkish, okay? This tree from that tree better is. It sounds weird in English, but that's the structure of Turkish. Okay, let's see. Okay, this movie is boring. If you want to say this movie is boring. What is boring? Sıkıcı. Sıkıcı. Bu film sıkıcı. Bu film sıkıcı. Okay, if I want to say this movie is more boring than that movie, then I would say bu film o filmden daha sıkıcı. Bu film o filmden daha sıkıcı. And again, the literal translation is this movie from that movie more boring is. Okay? That's the structure of Turkish. Let's see another example. Let's say Özlem is tall. Özlem uzun. Özlem uzundur. So, let's say Özlem is taller. Then we would say Özlem daha uzun. Özlem daha uzun. Okay? Let's say Özlem is taller than Seda. Okay? Özlem Seda'dan daha uzun. Özlem Seda'dan daha uzun. So as you can see, we use dan'dan from to make a comparison. So the again the literal translation is Özlem dan Seda, of course, but literally from Seda taller is. That's the structure. Okay, so this is the basic of the comparatives. Let's look at the superlatives, okay? What is a superlative? Superlative is the best, the most, okay? The tallest, things like that. So, to make that, it's again easy, we just add an before the adjective. Like, en güzel, the most beautiful, or en sıkıcı, the most boring, or en pahalı, the most expensive. Just we add en and that's all, okay? So, if I want to say Özlem is the tallest, I would say Özlem en uzun. Or if I want to say my mom is the best, then I would say annem or benim annem en iyi. If we want to say things like, for example, my mom is the best among the moms, something like that, among or among all. If you want to say something like that, I would add it like this. Benim annem anneler içinde en iyi or en iyidir. My mom amongst moms is the best. And let me check another example. I forgot my examples. Okay, let's try to say my house is the most beautiful house among other houses. Benim evim diğer evler içinde en iyidir. Benim evim diğer evler içinde en iyidir. Benim evim diğer evler içinde en iyidir. You can just say it the simple way, just adding an before the adjective, or you can add amongs or things like that if you want to emphasize that it's the best, it's the en of whatever. But generally, that is the concept. If you want to make a comparative, you add daha, more. And if you want to make a superlative, you add an, the most. That's the basic thing. So, let's give you an example, and I prepared something really funny. I will show it to you. I don't know if you see. Let's see. Do you see? Do you see my crazy girls here? This is Aslı. She's the tallest. This is Selin. She's in the middle. And this is Pelin. And she's the shortest. I had to do this to remember to my comparison. Okay. So, if I want to say Aslı is the tallest, I would say Aslı en uzun. If I want to say Pelin is the shortest, Pelin en kısa. Again, Aslı en uzun. Aslı en uzun. Pelin en kısa. Pelin en kısa. So, if I want to say Selin is shorter than Aslı, then I can say, can you try to make it? I'll give you 10 seconds. Okay? Selin Aslı'dan daha kısa. Selin is shorter than Aslı. Selin Aslı'dan daha kısa. Selin Aslı'dan daha kısa. Or if I want to say Selin is taller than Pelin, I would say Selin Pelin'den daha uzun. Selin Pelin'den daha uzun. Why I found names like that, I don't know. Selin Pelin. Selin Pelin'den daha uzun. For example, if I want to say Selin Pelin is the shortest among the girls. Pelin is, not English of course. Pelin kızlar içinde en kısa. Pelin kızlar içinde en kısa. Pelin kızlar içinde en kısa. And the last one, let's say Aslı is the tallest among the girls. Aslı is the, why I keep saying it in English. Aslı kızlar içinde en uzun. Aslı kızlar içinde en uzun. So that's it. You get the idea, right? It's not that hard. You just add en or daha before the adjective, and now you can compare and, you know, use comparatives and superlatives. I hope you liked it. I will see you next time. See you. Bye.
Want to speed up your language learning? Take your very first lesson with us. You'll start speaking in minutes and master real conversations. Sign up for your free lifetime account. Just click the link in the description.